years. Again, this your, you know, for Python control statements. Earlier we have discussed like keywords, identifiers and all. Now we are going to discuss about control statements. So here, what is we need to control? What we need to control first? So there is a flow which need to be either diverted or need to be flowed straight forward. Let us consider a river which is flowing straight forward. In order to control the water, we will construct a dam. In the same way, we can use a condition which can be used for controlling the statements. Flow of statements we can control using for loop, while loop or if conditions. Based on this condition, it will go in the straight way or in the given direction. So here you can see clearly that if you have a direction, yes, that means the condition satisfied, it will flow straight forward. Otherwise it will divert to the other path and flow. So what is we really going to achieve here? We are going to achieve that based on the required condition satisfaction, we are going to run certain statements, So here we have three types. One is if, another one is for, another one is while. Let us check the syntax. So the syntax for if is, if a condition, a colon and an indent of which can be a 4-space or 2-space based on the standardized which you use. Earlier than 3.6 Python version will use 4 spaces, where the later versions are using 2 spaces of indent. So here you can see the industrial standard. I have used 4 spaces and the statements I have written. Here if is can be followed by elif, where an elif is an alternative condition for if. You, then after for elif also you can check a condition, then you can follow up the statements. If the first if condition is failed, then it check the elif condition and run the statements. If elif also failed, then it, the final case it will be else. Final case will be else. So here only you can observe that the special character colon is used whenever there is a condition. Okay, the first statements there will be no special characters for ending a line. So this is about if condition. So first if condition failed, then it will check elif, and elif is failed, then we can have else. There can be as number of as elif for any program. So it is not limited. You can write n number of elifs, then the final else. So here we can clearly observe it is completely based on the condition which you are giving, or the final else which doesn't have any condition, and that will be the final statement for that flow. Then we have our second type is for loop. So for loop we will generally use for particular number of loop, a particular number of rotations. So if you know the number of times you want to execute, a line, then we can simply use a for loop. So here it for an object in sequence, an object in sequence will take and it will be used in the statements. So an object in the sequence will be taken and used in the statements. So here we can use a range of function, to which you need to give the input how many times the for loop need to be executed. So based on this, that number we can execute and control the number of executable lines in the for loop. Next it comes with while loop. So while we check a condition, after verifying the condition, if the condition is satisfied, we will execute the statements. Otherwise we won't execute. We can achieve an infinite loop with while loop, where it can't be achieved in for loop. So an infinite loop can be achieved with while loop, and infinite loop cannot be achieved with for loop. We will use for loop when we know certain range, that means how many times we need to execute, we will use for loop. Where coming to while, we can use both for infinite loop as well as a number of iteration, iterable condition, okay? Based on the condition it will work, based on the sequence it will work. So this is about the control statements which we use generally in Python. For more queries, we can use come and learn in Bison Technologies. For online training, you can reach over gangboard.com.